الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه الله اليقين. ابتعثه الله ليخرج العباد من عبادة العباد لعبادة رب العباد، ومن ضيق الدنيا لسعة الدنيا والآخرة معا، ومن جور الأديان إلى عدل الإسلام. فاللهم اجزه عنا خير ما جزيت بين أمته. I praise Allah. We praise Him together. We praise Him and thank Him and seek Him and seek His help and ask His forgiveness. And we seek refuge in Allah from the curse of Satan and from bad deeds we've done and from habits we hang on to, whether because it's hard for us to give them up or because we like them too much. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil within us and from bad deeds and temptations and from the curse of Satan. And we ask His help and His forgiveness. And we ask Him for sincerity in our words and deeds. And we ask Him to send His peace and His blessings upon our beloved Muhammad, peace and blessings upon Him, the final messenger and prophet, that He sent with the truth and the light. He sent Him to free us, to liberate the entire human family, to liberate earth from enslavement to each other, to the servitude of the Lord of creation, and from the constraint of knowing nothing but living on earth, to the freedom and emancipation that comes with knowing of the afterlife and the goodness that comes with it for those who live a good life on earth, and from the injustice of making decisions based on our own conclusions of what's best for us personally or what's best for our own country at the expense of others, to the justice and freedom that comes with divinely guided decision making that takes everyone into account, takes the well-being of earth as the created being of God into account, that takes the well-being of the human family with the job that God gave us on earth into account. So may Allah, the High and Exalted, the Glorified, give Muhammad peace and blessings upon him, the best reward that he has given a prophet and a messenger for his nation. Whomever Allah guides is the one who's guided, and whomever he leaves to stray, you'll never find for him a guardian nor a guide. Allah High and Exalted, He sent down upon Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him, the Qur'an, with its guidance and the solutions to all things. And as it was being revealed upon our beloved, there were occasions to bring about the revelation. And one of those occasions was when a group of his enemies wanted to discredit his message. So they searched for a way to discredit him. And the way that they came up with was to find out from earlier scripture questions that only a prophet would know, and to ask him those questions. And the answer to those questions came down in Revelation, a chapter that's recommended to us by Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that we recite it every single Friday of our lives. The questions that were asked, the first one was, tell us about the sleepers of the cave. And the question that was asked, it was an interesting occasion for the Prophet because it was asked of him, and the story about the sleepers of the cave, and in the books, in the scriptures, and in the texts that were among the rabbis of the Jewish tribes at the time, had variations. So their plan that was discussed among his enemies was that if he came with an answer, for instance, of how many the sleepers were, the sleepers of Ephesus, as it's known in the biblical sighting of it, that if the answer came with, for a certain number, that he would be discredited by using one of the texts that varies from that number. And if he came with the other one, they would discredit him with the original number. So the plan was to discredit him regardless. So Allah reveals, discrediting everyone, سيقولون ثلاثة رابعهم كلبهم ويقولون خمسة سادسهم كلبهم رجما بالغيب ويقولون سبعة وثامنهم كلبهم. Allah reveals all the numbers that are in the different texts about how many sleepers they were. And then he says that the number seven or eight is the closest. قُلْ رَبِّي أَعْلَمُ بِعِدَّتِهِ مَا يَعْلَمُ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ. What is the story of the sleepers of Ephesus and why? Why is it the first story that we're supposed to learn every single Friday, that we're supposed to refresh ourselves on every single Friday? And what is it that some of us who have studied it, maybe every single Friday since we were born, what about it do we actually not really know, not understand the implications of it for our lives in America?